the Harlem Shake. We're gonna start. No, we're saving it for later.
Oh.
We will.
Here we go.
That's Friday, a, that's the beginning of the. Oh, don't worry, it's gonna be a loose Friday.
Whoa! What's that?
Go!
He broke the previous record set in Taiwan in 2011 by 5 minutes. Needless to say, celebrations are now in full swing.
Oh, Georgie.
Pad ties all round, Georgie.
Why not, Carl?
Go to number 33. Thank you for that.
That's the wrong country, Lisa.
Well, you know, there's a few
number
of them.
No, number 33 with cashew nuts.
Chinese, not Thai.
No. My local Thai has numbers.
Well, I just think that's kind of racist.
I like photos. Do you like photos?
Oh, photos are good, yeah. And the fake ones in the window are good as well.
My apologies. I'll talk on behalf of my co-host. She has her own views.
Let's have a look at the...
You are a troublemaker.
Well, dolphin today, but Moki and Starbuck wanted to say good morning to you first, Carl and Lisa.
Oh,
stop your whining.
Thank you, Steve. You know, Lisa does a great dolphin impersonation. Is it an impersonation?
Yeah.
Go. That's right, Flipper.
Yeah, there's a lot of Flipper.
They're in big trouble, those players, aren't they? Really? All right. Those allegations coming up in about 5 minutes' time.
Oh,
but,
that's very good.
It's the word from the dolphin's mouth.
Oh, how amazing
that
footage.
The story really freaks me out. I was saying to you in the during the story that I actually went to a psychic once. This is a true story, and the psychic told me in a previous life I'd been attacked by a shark.
Really?
The weirdest thing is, there's actually, if you feel here, there's actually like a bite mark.
Ouch!
Good morning to you, Carl. It is Wednesday, the 13th of February. That means everyone has got exactly 24 hours to get ready for Valentine's Day.
Oh.
Okay, I just thought I'd give you the heads up on that.
I've got less than that, actually.
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
especially with, all your chicks, Dickie.
Probably starts at midnight. Stop that. It probably starts at midnight, though, doesn't it?
It does for you.
Oh, stop it.
You got a lot to get in there, Dickie.
Stop it.
Oh, sorry, mate.
Well, I'm going. Yeah, I'd like to sell a job. No. I got work to do.
Oh. Yeah, walk off early.
Wow.
Oh, sorry, Richard.
Sorry.
Oh, he's the romantic
amongst us. He's the lethargic.
Isn't he?
He's the romantic, is what he is. Good morning to you.
Our very own Rod Stewart.
Yeah.
Morning to you. You are watching the Today Show. Happy Valentine's Day to you. And as you can tell from one glance at me, I am a genuine romantic. And while Stevie Jacobs swanning around the flower markets, yes, I am, this morning trying to buy roses for his missus, let me give you some cold, hard facts. This Valentine's Day, Australians will spend around $14.2 million on cards. But can I give you a piece of advice? Turn up with just a card for Valentine's and you'll be in the doghouse for 6 months. Better turn up with nothing. It's about a month in purgatory, I reckon, nothing. 6 months for just a card. Now, chocolates, that's the big area. More than $300 million worth of chocolates will be sold today, which is an awful lot of zits to give to your loved one, I think. Plus also Easter's early this year, just a month or so away. So I'd really be careful about the chocolates, right? Jewellery, that's $17 million if that's sold for Valentine's Day. Settle down, Carl. According to Ibis World, now I think save the jewellery for anniversaries, birthdays, or maybe proposing, which I suppose you can do on Valentine's Day if you're really lacking any other smart idea. Clothing and intimate apparel. Clothing and intimate apparel. Do really people give this away for Valentine's Day? There's, what's this, $66 million worth of that? Give me a break. Now listen, the biggest ticket item, romantic getaways. Now this year it said that there'll be $437 million worth of hotels and travel booked for Valentine's Day. Now I reckon that'd be great if it was Friday, but Valentine's is Thursday. Kind of takes the sting out of a dirty long weekend, doesn't it? So there you go, romantics. Here you go, $936 million. Yes? What, we going?
It's about the romance, Ross. You stand in the corner there for half an hour. There he is. Ross Greenwood standing there for half an hour.
What
it was a bit of a downer, wasn't it, folks? Bit of a downer on this Valentine's Day. What are you going to buy? One share in BHP Billiton, Ross? Hey, that's romantic. Oh, let's get a Commonwealth Bank share.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Just one of them for your loved one this season.
Good for people.
You stay right there in the corner. Contacted by Beyonce's publicist, asking them to respectfully remove them. They refuse. Anyone can be taken in those sort of weird situations, though, can't they?
Mm, like, still looks pretty good.
For example, like just 2 minutes ago. Fordo, can we get that photo removed of me? That's good.
See? And that's there forever now.
Yeah, what are you going to do about that? Have to get your publicist onto it, Carl.
We've got to get a publicist.
That's going to go viral.
The Today Show, live from Los Angeles, thanks to the Coffee Club.
Don't be grumpy. Don't be grumpy. You want to come, don't you? No, there's still time. We can still ask the boss. Come on, sit up. Come on. You'll be better. Come on, come on.
Don't touch me.
Come on. You want to wear a frock, don't you? You're jealous about the frock. Well, I don't know what I can do about that. Maybe if you can wait until the Christmas party, we can organise a frock for you then. Okay, all right.
Good morning again. Well, the Academy Awards are under 3 weeks away, and as we speak, all the nominees are attending the annual Oscars luncheon, as Georgie told us in news. Jackie was one of the first to hit the stage and was asked how she reflects and thinks, yep, now I've made it.
Now, listen, ladies, if you will excuse me, I have to jet off to pick up my little bubba. Aww. So I'll see you next weekend. Happy New Year.
We'll see you next year.
Lay one on me. Yes, I owed you that. And that is my tip for all you single fellas out there for New Year's. Later, loser.
The headline behind you, Lisa, the Pope resigns.
We thought we'd resigned.
Yeah. It's not resigns. It's kind of a bit weird the way that works.
Yeah, no worries.
Thanks for clearing that.
Look, that was one flight.
Yeah, but it went for 16 hours.
It was actually 24, but you know, who's counting? No,
maybe you lost your shoe and then. No, you lost your phone.
Found it in his shoe.
Don't start. He's walking around, he goes, I've got something under my foot. Takes his shoe off.
I'm just hitting
my phone.
Thank you, Forda. I'm just hitting the exit button.
Whatever happened to the old mate sack? It's gone. Let's get the weather.
Hey, Carl and Lisa, did you hear about the octopus on the dance floor?
No.
No.
Pulled a muscle.
Oh, good. That's very good, Stevie.
That's very
good. No, that's allowed. Just. Thanks, Stevie.
Well, forget Nintendo and PlayStations. The pogo stick used to be the toy.
Oh, that's okay. I didn't need that tooth.
Well, this has been coming for some time, hasn't it? Lisa and I are having an almighty stoush in the kitchen.
That's right.
Who is going to win? It's Pancake Tuesday. Lisa's going first.
Okay, so we're not going to bother with aprons. We're manning up, are we? Okay. Now, this is an old family recipe for blueberry pancakes. We start off with 1.5 cups of ordinary white flour.
You're reading that, don't you know it off by heart?
Because I tend to sort
of... Oh, maybe it's not your recipe.
No, I tend to throw everything in all at once. Mix all of that around, and then you put in your wet ingredients. Now, this is buttermilk. Buttermilk is really good for you. It's what you end up with when you take away the cream and they make actual butter out of, and it's really good for you. It's got lots of probiotics in it, and it's very good for your gut. Throw your blueberries on top like that. Okay, how are you going, Carl?
Well, Lisa, I don't need 4 hours to do my pancake recipe that's been in the family for 100 years.
Yeah.
You just get one of these things from the supermarket. Whack a little funnel in it. Oh, this is really taxing. Oh, and I haven't got time to spend 4 hours in the kitchen making pancakes, so I take, what's that been, 30 seconds?
That's so not fair.
And it's sexy.
Is that made, are you doing that with love? You're doing it with sexy, but I don't know it's made with love. A nut.
There we go. One, two. Trend that Ellen is starting on her Ellen show called Koalaring. Yeah. We gave that a shot just a little earlier. This is the koala. Oh. That's rock solid, Dickie.
That's good. Look at that. You're wondering what to hang on to there, weren't you?
He didn't know it was coming either. I was pretending to take a photo of him. Yeah,
you Dickie. Funsters.
Oh.
That's our own koalery go.
Georgie looks relaxed.
That's
okay.
Really relaxed.
Coming up on
mornings. That's going to end up in court, that one. Oh.